So like, some say that Sri Brahma ji is the creator, some say Sri Vishnu ji is Satgun ji's creator, some say Tamogun Shiv ji is the creator, and some say that Sri Brahma Rajogun is the creator of all universes, pious souls. So this is folklore. And some who worship Durga say that Durga is the creator of everyone. The ones who worship Sri Devi ji believe her to be the supreme. And the ones who worship Brahm, they believe him to be supreme. So pious souls, first we will have to see this map. We will again look at the map in the form of our holy books and we will see what guidance we get from them. Then we will get the satisfaction. Until now, we are listening to different things about gods from people. Some great sage has given some form of knowledge. And we are students, we are devout. Whatever knowledge, whichever saint gives us about the God, we believe it without any doubts, without any objection, we accept it. So, pious souls, we need to first have the knowledge about who is God. We should have this information with us. And then, we will succeed on the path towards God. Then no one will be able to confuse us. It is said in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, chapter number 16, verse number 23, those who reject the injunctions of holy scriptures and follow the way of worship according to their willfulness, that is, oppose the teachings of holy scriptures, undertake obeisance of their wish, which is not present in holy books, that obeisance is futile. They neither move to higher realms, nor do they get any happiness or any powers. That is, it is useless. Then immediately in the 24th verse of 16th chapter of Gita ji, it is said that for you, Arjun, determining what is to be done and what is forbidden. Kartavya means the obeisance that we were to do and what we want to do. The ones we should give up and the ones we should accept are based on the evidences from holy books. Do not trust the folklores. Then it is said in Gita ji, chapter 2, verse 53, O Arjun, when your mind will deviate from various types of knowledges that confuses you and will stabilize on just one spiritual knowledge on that Supreme God, then you will receive devotion. And then you will become a devotee. At that time, your obeisance will begin when you will stick on the one true knowledge, when your mind will focus on knowledge in accordance to our holy books, you will not quiver and you will move forward on right path. Whatever steps you put on this path, it will be favorable for you. It will be beneficial for you. Now, there is a lot of confusion about the creation of nature. Like, for instance, people following Jainism, devotees, preachers, they say, there is no creator of this nature and there is no destroyer too. It is eternal. It gets created on its own and gets destroyed on its own. It is not like this. There are many other devotees. Some say Vishnu ji is the creator. Like I already told before. Today I will tell you about this in special details. Now, as the scenario of God Kabir Dev ji was going on, that he is complete almighty. He is complete Brahm, complete God. You will not be able to believe this until you become aware of his qualities. And where are these qualities? These are written in life history, their autobiography. For instance, the details about Sri Vishnuji, Shivji, Brahmaji can be found in their life history. It is written in their histories, Puranas. Similarly, God Kabirji's glory is written in Sukshm Ved, in Sukshma Ved. This servant had read in the history of Adi Shankaracharya ji that too he has supported the existence of it. Adi Shankaracharya ji had said that four Vedas, Rig Ved, Yajur Ved, Athar Ved, Sam Ved are available here and the fifth one is Sukshma Ved. Now the reason for this was that the fifth Ved, Sukshma Ved on Mount Kailash was destroyed by Kal. God himself descends from Satlok to provide that Sukshma Ved. He descends here from eternal place. He comes to give us the knowledge that was destroyed by Satan. All that hidden knowledge that was destroyed by Kal, by this Brahm, he has kept it hidden. He doesn't get it exposed to anyone. So, to tell about that, fifth Ved God comes here. It is written in that fifth Ved, that information from that Ved, that knowledge was spoken by God from His holy mouth about 600 years ago. That is why it is said in Gita Ji chapter 4 verse 32 that Arjun, in Gita Ji chapter 4 from verse number 25 to 31, it is said, some worship God, some do self-study of scripture, some perform fasting and non-violence. Some think that they are successful just by doing pranayam. The detailed information about all this knowledge, about these religious rituals, is given in Gita Ji chapter 4 verse 32, that it is in the voice of Sachidanand Ghan Brahma, the complete God. Here in Gita Ji chapter 4 verse number 32, due to lack of spiritual knowledge, these translators have misinterpreted this verse. It is written as Brahmane Mukhe. In the original script, translators have translated Brahmane Mukhe as in the voice of Vedas. This is wrongly written. It is wrong translation. Brahmane Mukhe means in the voice of Sachidanand Ghan Brahma, which God speaks from His own mouth. A fairly detailed account of it is given in the words spoken by God Himself, and that is Kabir Vani. They have translated Brahmane wrongly here. They wrote Veda, and in Gita Ji chapter 17 verse 23, Om Tat Sat Iti Nirdeshah Brahmane Trividah Smritah. They have translated Brahmane correctly because they did not get distracted. They have written the meaning of Brahmane as Sachidanand Ghan Brahma. So here in the verse 32 of chapter 4, we will have to write the meaning of word Brahmane as Sachidanand Ghan Brahma in given details. Then in chapter 4 verse 34, it is said that true spiritual knowledge is written in the fifth Veda, the Sukshma Ved. And to understand that true spiritual knowledge, take the refuge of an enlightened saint, prostrating before them and asking them questions without any deception, that enlightened saint will give you the true spiritual knowledge. This also proves the fact that the giver of knowledge of Gita is not aware about the fifth Veda. Therefore, he has left this option that to understand this true spiritual knowledge, you will have to take refuge of an enlightened saint. So God Kabir Dev Ji himself descends to play the role of an enlightened saint. So 600 years ago, because God Kabirji had descended on earth in the form of a human baby and he had appeared on a lotus flower in a pond named Leher Tara in Kashi city, now Varanasi. In 1398 AD, that is 1455 in the month of June of Vikram Samvat, Hindu calendar. And he grew up performing marvels. He was taken by a weaver couple named Niru Nima. And being in that occupation, he was called a Julaha or a Dhanak, He has told and written in that Sukshma Ved 600 years ago. This servant wants to bring that knowledge to you in my own words.